Hi, my name is Sitamcoder, and in this video I'm going to show you how to use the basic splines in the Unreal Editor. The first thing you need for a spline path is to open the content browser, select the Actor Classes tab, and search for a spline. Then drag a spline actor into the viewport to create a new instance, and just alt-drag the next one out of the old one. A UDK then automatically connects the two spline actors with a new curve. The curve is interpolated between the two points and their tangents, which are indicated by this white line. You can modify the tangent by clicking it and dragging it along, or by double-clicking the actor, opening the properties and setting the values manually. If you want to create a new connection between two spline actors, select the two actors and hit the dot key on your keyboard. And there you have a new connection. If you want to reverse this connection, you can hit the dot key again and reverse connections between spline actors. Breaking connections is quite simple too. You hold Alt and click on the connection to remove it. If you want to copy spline curves, you have to hit Ctrl C and Ctrl V, because if you alt drag, for every selected spline a new spline will be created and all the previous connections will be broken. Now that you know how to use the basic splines, let me show you a network that I've set up to use for pathfinding. You can select the start and the goal spline and test the pathfinding by right-clicking and selecting spline test route. And UDK will automatically create a green line if it has found a path, or if it cannot find a path, will give you an error message. These red connections indicate that this spline is deactivated. You can deactivate splines in a network by opening the properties and clicking the Disable Destination checkbox, which will then be treated like there is no connections. This is good for dynamically changing networks, and you can access all the functions from script later. The other type of spline actor in the UDK is the loft spline, which is used to deform static meshes on the spline curve. And that can be quite handy for procedurally generating repetitive meshes like fences, roads, veins, routes, or in this case rails. But using these actors is complicated, so I'll cover that in a later tutorial.